so often, because Radha Maharaj is hardly here, and it didn't collide when I'm here. Maharaj was here, I didn't happen to be here, or when I came here, Radha Maharaj was not here, so I was not feeling inspired to come that way. So anyway, I'm very happy to be here, to be with you all. Jai Radha Madhava Kunja Vihari. Jai Radha Madhava Kunja Vihari. Gopi Jana Vallabha Girivardhari. Jaya Gopijana Vallabha Girivardhari. Jashoda Nandana Brajajana Ranjana. Jashoda Nandana Braja Janaranjana. Jamuna Tira Banachari. Jamuna Tira Banachari. Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Vihari. Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Vihari. Gopijana Vallabha Girivardhari. Jaya Gopijana Vallabha Girivardhari. Jashoda Nandana Brajajana Ranjana. Jashoda Nandana Brajajana Ranjana. Jamuna Tira Banachari. Jamuna Tira Banachari. Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Vihari. Jaya Radha Madhava Kunja Vihari. Jayung Vishnupad Paramhansa Parivrajaka Charjo Ashtottarashato Shri Srimad Abhay Charanar Bindu Bhakti Vedanta Swami Prabhupad Ki Jai Anant Koti Vaishnav Vrind Ki Jai Shri Shri Radha Gopinath ki, Shri Shri Gaur Nithai ki jai, Shri Shri Giridhari Gopal ki jai, Samaveto Bhakta Vrinda ki, Gaur Premanande Hari Hari Bo. All glories to the assembled devotees, all glories to the assembled devotees, all glories to the assembled devotees, all glories to Sri Guru and Sri Gauranga, all glories to Srila Prabhupada. Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishthaya Bhutale, Srimate Bhaktivedanta Swami Niti Namine, Namaste Sharashati Deve Gauravani Pracharine, Nirvishesha Shunnavadi Paschatta Dishatarine, Srila Prabhupada. Hare Krishna. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Narayanam Namaskritya. Narancheiva Narottamam Deving Sarasatim Vyasam Tato Jaya Mudirai Nashta Prayeshu Abhadreshu Nittam Bhagavata Sevaya Bhagavati Uttama Shloke Bhaktir Bhavati Naishtiki. Srimad Bhagavatam, 11th Canto, Chapter 20. This chapter is entitled as Pure Devotional Service. Text 24. Jamadi Bhir Yoga Pathair Annik Anvikshikya Cha Vidyaya Mamarcho Pa Shanadi Shanabhirva Mamarcho Pa Shanabhirva Nannair Yogam Smarin Manaha Jamadi Bhir Jogopathair Annikshikya Cha Vidyaya Mamar Chopa Shana Bhirva Nannair Yogam Smarin Manaha Jamadi Bhir Yoga Pathair Annikshikya Cha Vidyaya Mamar Chopa Shana Bhirva Nannair Yogam Smarin Manaha Jamadi Bhir Jogopathair Annikshikya Cha Vidyaya Mamar Chopa Shana Bhirva Nannair Yogyam Smarin Manaha
Yeah.
Mataji's. Jamadibhi, by disciplinary regulations, etc. Yogopathai, by the procedures of the yoga system. Anvikshikya, by logical analysis. Cha, also. Vidya, by spiritual knowledge. Momo, my, archa, worship, upasana bhi, by adoration, etc. Va, or, na, never, annai, by other means, yogyam, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, the object of meditation, smarit, one should focus on manaha, the mind. A translation. Throughout the various disciplinary regulations and the purificatory procedures of the yoga system, through logic and spiritual education, or through worship of adoration of me, one should constantly engage his mind in remembering the personality of Godhead, the goal of yoga. No other means should be employed for this purpose. Please repeat after me. Throughout the various disciplinary regulations and the purificatory procedures of the yoga system, through logic and spiritual education, or through worship and adoration of me, one should constantly engage his mind in remembering the personality of Godhead, the goal of yoga. No other means should be employed for this purpose. Purport. The word va is significant in this verse, for it indicates that one engaged in the worship and adoration of the personality of Godhead need not trouble himself with the disciplinary, regulatory, and purificatory procedures of yoga, nor with the grueling intricacies of Vedic studies and logic. Yogam, or the most appropriate object of meditation, is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, as confirmed throughout the Vedic literature. One who directly takes to the worship of the Lord should not employ other methods, for full dependence on the Lord is in itself the supreme process of perfection. Jamadibhir yogopathair annikshikya cha vidyaya mamarchito upasana bhirba nanair yogam smarin manaha. Through the various disciplinary regulations and the purificatory procedures of the yoga system, through logic and spiritual education, or through worship and adoration of me, one should constantly engage his mind in remembering the personality of Godhead, the goal of yoga. No other means should be employed for this purpose. So, Krishna is advising Uddhava. Uddhava realized that Krishna was going to wind his pastimes soon. So he expressed his desire to Krishna that he wanted to go with him. But Krishna discouraged him, said, no, you stay back on this planet. And Krishna suggested that he take sannyas. And then Krishna advised Uddhava. And that advice is, this is a part of that advice that Krishna is giving in the 11th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, which is known as Uddhava Gita. There is Bhagavad Gita that was spoken to Arjuna. There is Uddhava Gita. In this way there are various Gitas. There is another one, Brahma Gita. Then also, anyway, so there are various Gitas, and this is considered to be one of the most important instructions, because here Krishna is gradually giving Uddhava the ultimate perfection of life. And this chapter is entitled as the Pure Devotional Service. And time again that has been pointed out in the Vedas. The purpose of the Vedas is Vedaischa Sarvair Ahameva Vedya. In all the Vedas only Krishna is to be understood. And understanding Krishna naturally leads to the point of devotional service. Akali Ishwar Krishna Arshava Vritta. Only Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and everyone else is his servant. And the servant's business is to serve. And the service is simply due to an expression of love, loving devotional service. So everybody's actual business is to become engaged in this loving devotional service or pure devotional service. Jnana karmad anabritam. And in the particular verse also Krishna is making the same point, that all other procedures, they generally fall in these two categories, karma or jnana. But pure devotional service is free from the tinge of or effect or influence or covering of jnana and karma. Anna bhilashita sunnam, no other desire besides serving Krishna. And jnana karmad anabritam, no more desire for jnana and karma. Karma means action. The body is, body's function is action, activities. Body's desire, body's function is to enjoy. And act in such a way that you will be able to enjoy. Achieving the goal is not the main consideration. The main consideration is how you get it, how you achieve that goal. Somebody may think that to get a lot of money is the goal. His goal is to get a lot of money. And he robs a bank, gets the money, but is arrested and put into prison. He got the money, but he is not able to enjoy that, because this is not the right way to get it, right way to achieve the goal. So Karmakanda section of the Vedas are pointing out how to act in such a way that you will be able to fulfill your desire, because the fulfillment of desire leads to happiness. And the Vedas, like a desire tree, can fulfill anybody's, any desire in the material nature. One wants to become a rich man, Vedas are saying, okay, act in this way. Perform these activities, you'll become rich. One wants to become a king, Vedas are pointing out how to become a king. In spite of being a king, he is not happy. He wants to become a monarch. He wants to become the ruler of the entire earth planet. Fine. Vedas are saying, fine. If that is your desire, do this and you'll fulfill your desire. You are not happy just being the ruler of the entire earth planet. You want to get the position of Indra, become the ruler of the heavenly planet. Vedas are saying, fine. Perform these activities or sacrifices. And this is how one has the ability to get the highest position in the universe, position of Lord Brahma. But no matter how much one enjoys or tries to enjoy, one realizes eventually that he is suffering. The intelligent conclusion is it's going to lead to suffering. Everything is leading to suffering. Therefore, he considers, why am I suffering? That actually takes him to the Gyanakanda section of the Vedas. And he recognizes that this is a place for suffering, this dukkhalayam ashvashatam. This is a place of suffering. So how can you enjoy in a place of suffering? There is no enjoyment actually. No real enjoyment. Therefore, the consideration is just get out of this suffering condition. So karma leads to enjoyment, bhukti, and jnana leads to liberation or mukti. But the consideration is, even when you become liberated, then what? Then that leads to bhakti. Bhukti, mukti, finally bhakti or devotional service. Simple consideration, just getting out of the prison is not the ultimate consideration. There are two ways you can get out of the prison. One is you can dig a tunnel and get out of the prison. But that's not going to lead to fulfillment of real desire. To be out and enjoy. Rather, you get out of the prison, but the whole police force is after you. You have to hide in forest or in all kinds of places, don't get food to eat, don't get a place to sleep. Rather, when you are in the prison, you at least had the food to eat and place to sleep. And now getting out of this prison in this way, you don't even have that facility. Therefore, this is considered to be the negative liberation. But there are positive liberations. That positive liberation is actually leading to bhakti. You can get out of the prison by digging a tunnel out of the prison or any such means, but that's not the right way to get out of the prison. The right way to get out of the prison is find out why you are imprisoned. And then you get to know that you broke the law of the king. That's why you are imprisoned. So, then you recognizing that you had committed an offense to the king by breaking his law or defying his law, not abiding by his law. So then he writes a note to the king. I'm extremely sorry. I broke your laws. I promise from now on I'll never ever, I'm completely surrendered unto you. Then the prisoner says, okay, fine. Then the king says, okay, let him out. He may not release him straight away. After getting that application, the king probably writes to the or contacts the prison authority and reports that this person seems to be correcting himself. So take care of him, see how he behaves. And the prison authorities keep on watching him and see that, oh, he's behaving nicely. Then prison authorities don't treat him like a prisoner, rather gives him facilities, makes him a role model to the other prisoners, that look, become like him. Then you'll also get these facilities, surrender to the king. And then this person himself goes and tells the other prisoners, that look, I surrendered unto the king, and this is the benefit that I am getting. Why are you suffering? Just surrender unto the king and you'll become free from all your suffering condition. And then finally, the king says, king sends a message to the prison authorities that I need a good servant. So please send him to my palace. So he's promoted straight from the prison house to the palace of the king, associating with the king. Now if we consider that condition or analogy, this material nature is a prison house. We can get out of the prison house by defying Krishna, rather trying to become Krishna. I will get out of the prison and then I'll become the king myself. That is called Sajujya Mukti. Sajujya Mukti is a liberation, a negative liberation. It's liberation, but it is actually negative liberation. It doesn't really solve the problem. Rather, it increases the problem. Because when he is arrested, then he is put into a more severe condition of imprisonment. But the positive ones are surrender to the king. As Krishna is saying, sarva dharman parityajya mam ekam sharanam braja aham tvang sarva papebhyo. The reason for your suffering is your pap, sinful activities. I will deliver you from all your sinful reactions. Don't worry, no more suffering. Just surrender unto me. And when one surrenders, then the authority of the prison house, Maya and other demigods, Mahamaya and the demigods, they don't treat him like a prisoner. They rather treat him like a good person. Oh, he surrendered. So give him more facilities. Not instead of suffering, he starts getting all kinds of benefits and facilities, although in the prison. And then he goes out and tells others, starts to preach. He surrenders and then he starts to preach, telling everybody, why don't you surrender? And then eventually, Krishna calls him. A chariot comes from Vaikuntha to take him there. So that is the benefit of devotional service. And that's the purpose of the Vedas. Apparently, karmakanda section and gyanakanda sections are there in the Vedas, but they are not leading to the ultimate consideration, ultimate point. They're just gradual elevation or gradual promotion. The main consideration is to become engaged in devotional service. And the Vedas are also pointing out why. Because we are his parts and parcels. Therefore, the fulfillment of our existence lies in becoming connected to Him. The purpose of the part's existence lies in its connection to the whole. This finger is a part of my body. If the finger is cut off from the body, what's the use of this finger? But when it's connected to the body, it's a part of the body, it's serving the body. And along with the body, the finger is enjoying. What to speak of Krishna, the supreme enjoyer, Anandamaya. So when you become connected to the Anandamaya, the supreme enjoyer, then automatically we become joyful. We do not have to separately endeavor for enjoyment as we are trying to do in the material nature. The problem in the material, our material existence, is that we are trying to achieve our spiritual needs through this body. This is due to our misidentification of our identity. Ahankar, false ego. Trying to identify ourselves with the body, considering the body to be the self, body to be me. And in reality, I am eternal, I am immortal, I am full of knowledge, and I am full of bliss. So, we are trying to achieve those spiritual attributes through this material body. And it never works. We keep on endeavoring, but it never achieves that. The way to achieve that state of existence is by becoming situated in our spiritual identity. And how can we become situated in spiritual identity? Simply by being connected to Krishna. That is the way to become, to regain our constitutional position. Our spiritual identity. In that respect, there's a very beautiful example in the Vedas. Just as a spark of fire. A spark of fire is qualitatively is fire. But tiny fire. But when that spark comes out of the fire, it loses its fiery qualities. And next to the fire is ash. And falling on the heap of ash, that was spark at one time now became ash. It became ash, losing all its fiery qualities. Now if that speck of inflammable object, if it wants to regain his fiery qualities, what does he have to do? Go back to the fire. And when it does that, then automatically he regains his fiery qualities. Of course, a spark cannot do it by itself, but a living entity can. So living entity is the tiny little spiritual spark. When it becomes separated from Krishna, he loses his spiritual identity, spiritual qualities. And falling into the heap of ash or this material nature, it becomes matter. It becomes material. Starts to identify himself with the body, which is made of matter. And that is our problem in this material nature. All of us are suffering from this problem due to our identification of this body as a self. Now how can we rectify that situation? Go back to Krishna, the supreme spiritual personality. And when we do that, when we become connected to Krishna, then we regain our spiritual identity, And these qualities, Satchidananda aspect, is already there in the spiritual self. So this is the process, simple process of just becoming connected to Krishna. Now the consideration is, how does one become connected? Connection means to become related. Now, when do we develop relationship? When we have love for that person. Love unites, hatred separates. So if we want to become connected to Krishna, then we have to offer our love to Him. And in simple words, that is the meaning of devotional service. Every living entity has love in his heart. He's offering this love to various objects in this material nature in his quest of happiness, in his quest of joy. But no matter wherever he reposes it, it's never fulfilled. Why? Because this love is actually meant to be offered to Krishna. Love is the means by which we can become connected to Krishna. And when that love is offered to Krishna, and the expression of that love naturally is to do something for Krishna. Therefore, loving devotional service. So, and that is the ultimate conclusion of the Vedas. Time and time again we are seeing that. In Bhagavad Gita we saw that. Krishna did speak about karma, Krishna did speak about jnana, but then finally conclusion is bhakti. Here also we are seeing the same thing. Similarly, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's discussion with Ramananda Rai started off with Varnashram, went through karma yoga, karma sannyas, jnana. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu rejected one after another. Not this, not this, not this. Until he came to the point of devotion. Yes, that's it. Now elaborate. So that is the conclusion of the Vedas, and that's the real understanding of the Vedas. The Vedas are actually pointing out that the ultimate goal of life is to become engaged in loving devotional service to Krishna. And we are very fortunate that by the mercy of Srila Prabhupada we got it. By the mercy of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu it became available in this world, and Srila Prabhupada made it available to all of us. And that is our rare good fortune, inconceivable good fortune, that somehow or other we have come across Srila Prabhupada's mission. Somehow or other we have come across ISKCON. And through ISKCON we got this knowledge. Through Prabhupada's books we got this knowledge. And while we are practicing it, we are experiencing it. Yeah, it works. It works. We are happier than we used to be before. Our life is less problematic now than it used to be before. We got the taste of such a wonderful existence. Total freedom from anxiety. And that is the reward of, or that's the benefit of devotional service. As a seed sprouts into a seedling, the first thing comes is two leaves, right? Just two leaves. Similarly, when Bhakti Lata Beej sprouts into a seedling, there are two leaves are indicating Kleshagni. Kleshagni means no more suffering. Devotional service automatically leads us to a point where there is no more suffering, Kleshagni. As if the Klesha has been murdered. He's slain, he's dead. Kleshagni and Shubhada. auspiciousness. That is the immediate, or I'll say preliminary, benefit of being engaged in devotional service. And when we become engaged in devotional service, we can see, experience it ourselves. No more suffering. Why should we suffer? Why there should be suffering? Krishna is there, he is taking care of me in all respects. Why should I suffer? He is providing me and he is taking care of me in all respects. And because I have surrendered to him, my life has become full of auspiciousness. Kleshagni Shubhada. Practicing devotional service is not a blind thing. Devotional service comes with the benefits and the rewards or the reactions. When you become engaged in devotional service, things start to happen. Things start to happen internally. We experience, other may not experience it. Other may not find it, how it's happening. But the one who is practicing, he sees how it's working. So we have come to the right place. We found the right path. Now let's just stay on in this path and never deviate. And it's guaranteed that someday we'll end up in the spiritual world. Not only in the spiritual world, the topmost region of the spiritual world, Golok Vrindavan. And that's another reward of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, another gift of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He has given us something that's at the highest region of the spiritual world, beyond Vaikuntha, beyond the general region of the spiritual world, Golok. And what will happen? We have seen in Brihad Bhagavatamritam by Sanatan Goswami, Gop Kumar's journey. He's elevated to Vaikuntha, he's not satisfied. So similarly, because you got the right understanding or higher understanding, we're not going to settle for anything less than that. Even if we're elevated to Vaikuntha, we'll say, we're not really here. And well, as long as we are here, it's Krishna's mercy, but actually we want to go to that place. And one problem with Vaikuntha is that you can't preach there. That's one problem. Because Vaikuntha Vashis should not know about Golok Vrindavan. The residents of Vaikuntha do not have direct access to Golok Vrindavan. So this is the good fortune that we have. The residents of Vaikuntha, in order to have access to Golok Vrindavan, they have to come to the earth planet, practice Sankirtan in Vrindavan, then only they'll be able to or become eligible to go to Golok Vrindavan. And now consider, by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mercy, the door to Golok Vrindavan has become wide open to all of us. All we have to do is just have implicit faith in the process and practice it with all conviction. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. Gaur Premanande Hari Hari. If there is any question, maybe I can take one or two questions for about 5 minutes. Yes? Hare Krishna. How are you?
Hare Krishna Maharaj. Maharaj, after spending years and years in devotional life and understanding the depth of Krishna consciousness, one doubt comes in our mind that this philosophy is very practical. It goes into our heart also, and we are really blissful with this Krishna consciousness, and we don't want anything else other than Krishna consciousness. This conclusion we have come up. But one fear is there, that the standard which Mahaprabhu is selling, that we will be able to go to Golok Vrindavan, we will have this Gop Kumar's pastime and everything. Is it possible, Maharaj, that before leaving our body, we will get some type of a signal from Krishna that we are fit candidate for going, or we still have to come back again into this material world and repeat again and again? Is there any some indication?
When you get into a train to Delhi from Bombay, you do feel impatient. Why is it taking so long? But the thing is that you got into the right train, and if you just stay on the train, you will reach Delhi. Right? So similarly, you have found the right process, you got into the right vehicle, right? Sometimes you may feel impatient, sometimes you may feel doubt. Well, will it really reach but we have to have that conviction. Since it's the right train that you got into, it will reach destination. Doesn't matter how long it's going to take. So we shouldn't be impatient. Patiently, let's keep on enjoying our stay in the train that we have got into. It's a special vehicle where also 11th canto also gives that description that Nideham Adyam Guru Karna Dharam. This human body is like a boat. And where in that boat, the spiritual master is the captain, Karna Dharam. And it is blowing, it is moving with the words of Krishna. And in a similar note, in ISKCON also we have a painting that there is a boat, a ship, and on the flag of the mast, it says ISKCON. On the sail, there is a wind of Hare Krishna Mahamantra. And devotees are chanting and dancing on the deck, and Srila Prabhupada is steering the boat. So when he got into such a boat, you know, why should he have any worry about reaching our destination?
The problem that comes in our life is, we have understood that this is a very miserable place. In this place we have struck up. And by great mercy we have got such a wonderful association, such a wonderful path. And if we don't get the highest destination, then the fear has that again we have to come back. Again this birth, death, old age, disease. Again this nice association, will we get it or will not get it? And again we might miss the path and miss the track itself. Then what will happen? Why not get clear in this lifetime?
There we have to remember the fifth verse of Shikshashtakam. Mama janmani janmaneshware bhavatad bhakti rahaituk. If I have to come back again many, many times, Mahaprabhu is pointing out, don't worry about that. All we should pray that we can have bhakti or devotion to Krishna. So, you know, also Prabhupada pointed out, at a less advanced stage, one should aspire for liberation or getting out of the material nature. But as you become more advanced, then your attitude is, doesn't matter. I mean, this world is so wonderful, isn't it? So much opportunity to preach. So many prisoners are suffering in this prison house. So let's go and remind them how wonderful it is to surrender to Krishna and the wonderful benefit that you'll get out of that. You know? So the devotee's attitude is, doesn't matter how many times I have to come here. I don't mind, as long as I can remain Krishna conscious. So that should be our only prayer.
But the problem comes up with our anarthas are always haunting us in this place. And the fight is continuously going on, and sometimes we get really tired with our anarthas.
Well, you have found your devotion. Anarthas will automatically disappear. Anarthopo gamang shakshat. Performance of bhakti will take away anarthas. Therefore, what is needed is practicing the process in good association with devotees. Anyway, and I know you are asking these questions for our benefit. Thank you very much. You are advanced, you are very fixed up, I know. So,
Maharaj, one important which
I have a flight to catch. What to do? Should we take questions or should we skip breakfast? Okay, since you asked, then I'll take two more questions.
Maharaj, we are seeing you from last so many years. Huh? We are watching you from last so many years. Completely steadiness in your Krishna consciousness. I wanted to get one clarification from you is that so many years you are steadily going. Now your body, you are becoming old. Your body is not giving you the support which it was giving before. And still you are able to maintain your devotional life. Now the same problem we are also going to face in our life. What secret we have to keep in our mind so that enthusiasm and the commitment remains as steady as it was before?
I would say in simple words, by becoming aware of our obligation to Srila Prabhupada, he saved me. Therefore, this life is simply offered to him in his service. And Prabhupada himself has shown that. The kind of commitment that he displayed towards his spiritual master. Till the last moment he was serving him, translating the books to spread Krishna consciousness all over the world. So, I mean, if you ask the question like, you know, so as you asked first, so many years of commitment, you know, and that I will say about that, also again, Srila Prabhupada's mercy, because he closed the door behind me by giving me sannyas. I didn't have any place to go but carry on in this institution, rendering service unto him. And, you know, as you said, just yesterday I was telling somebody that when you grow old, your responsibilities reduce. But in ISKCON, as you grow old, your responsibilities keep on increasing. So anyway, these are all such wonderful challenges. And ultimately, you know, we are enjoying. We are enjoying. The enthusiasm is there because enjoyment is there. We are liking it. Okay, so I'll take your question, last question.
Krishna Maharaj, thank you so much for telling that analogy of how a prisoner is becoming a preacher within the prison itself. So my question is regarding the verse and the purport, where Prabhupada is telling the va word is very important and there is no need of entering into Vedic complicated conclusions or regulations, etc. of Yamadipita. At the same time, fixing mind on Krishna. Whereas we see in NOD, Uttam Adhikari, Madhyam Adhikari, these qualifications are given. There we see that for Uttam Adhikari, it is given that he is well, he is able to convince others by using Yukti, you know, in Krishna. And Madhyam Adhikari is one who is convinced himself, but he cannot convince others. So my question is, Maharaj, how to understand this, that do we have to consciously cultivate the knowledge part?
You see, the condition, the thing is that the devotee is very humble. He never thinks that I have become Uttamadhikari or Madhyamadhikari. The devotee always considers that, you know, I am lower than the blade of a grass. So he doesn't judge himself. But it's Krishna who decides. And another thing about spiritual life, you know, what really happens is, more you advance, more you realize how much you didn't advance or how you didn't really advance. So that is the unique aspect of spiritual life. We don't realize, oh, now I have come to a Madhyamadhikar platform. Or rather, devotee's mood is, oh, I couldn't even become a devotee. I mean, we find it from Uddhava also, considered to be the greatest devotee of Dwarka. Such an exalted devotee that when Narad Muni heard about him, you know, in ecstasy, he could not even walk straight. He was kind of, he was faltering, he was stumbling. Just, you know, about here, getting the opportunity to meet him, going to meet him. And that Uddhava is desiring to become a blade of grass in Vrindavan. Why? So that he could get the dust from the lotus feet of the gopis. When he went to Vrindavan and saw the gopis, their devotion to Krishna, their attachment to Krishna, he felt so humble. He was feeling that, I wish that I could Ashamaho Charano Renu Jushamaham Sham Vrindavane Kimoki Gulma Latoshadhinam. I wish I could become a blade of grass or a bush or a creeper in Vrindavan so that I could get the dust from the gopis' lotus feet. He knew that the gopis are not going to give him the dust of their feet. So he was desiring to get the dust of their feet. Just when they will run to meet Krishna, they may step onto him, and that's how he may get. So this is the attitude of the greatest of devotees, you know, so what to speak of us. So let's not worry about it. As I pointed out, like, we found the right path, just let's stay on that. And rest will happen by Krishna's mercy. Let's keep on. Mama janmani janmani share. Let it take life after life. Already so many lifetimes we have wasted. At least from this lifetime onwards, let's remain on the right track. Okay, I'm sorry that now I have to really go. Hare Krishna. Thank you all very much. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. Gaur Premanande Hare.